Welcome to The Point with me, Lu Xin, coming to you from Urumqi, the capital of northwest China's Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region. My guest today is Professor Chen Quanjia. He is Deputy Director of the Agricultural Institute of Xinjiang Agricultural University. And the topic, of course, cotton. Professor Chen, thank you very much for accepting our interview. I would like to know exactly what you have been doing with research on cotton and what has been your latest achievement in this field.
The main fields of my research are cotton genetic engineering and breeding. My work focuses on the basic and applied research of cotton. The ultimate goal is to produce new varieties of cotton suitable for cultivation in Xinjiang.
Were you born and raised in Xinjiang?
Yes, my parents came to Xinjiang in 1960 to support the frontier construction in border regions. Later, I was born and grew up here.
What are the advantages of Xinjiang that makes it particularly favorable for cotton growing?
Cotton is the main economic source of Xinjiang, especially for the farmers. Cotton farming accounts for about 50% of agricultural production in Xinjiang and contributes from 50% to 70% of cotton farmers' income. So cotton is particularly important for farmers in Xinjiang to increase their income.
And why there is such a heavy percentage of cotton in terms of agricultural production for Xinjiang?
One factor is the geographical conditions of Xinjiang. Xinjiang has a dry climate and moderate temperature. Abundant sunlight makes it easier for cotton to grow. That's why Xinjiang has always been an ideal place for large-scale cotton farming. Another factor is the widespread adoption of agricultural machinery in cotton farming in Xinjiang. Nowadays, the entire cotton farming process has been mechanized without the need for much manual labor. Thanks to full mechanization, a person can basically take care of 165 acres of land while maintaining the yield and quality of cotton. The third reason is that researchers and cotton farmers, in their long-standing practice, have been constantly enhancing the role of technology in cotton farming, so that the cotton in Xinjiang not only has high yield and good quality, but also can be farmed in such a large area.
Why is the level of mechanization so high in Xinjiang in cotton production?
The level of mechanization in cotton production in Xinjiang is so high mainly because of large-scale farming. In giant farms, it's easy to achieve mechanized production. Another reason is the government's long-standing support for Xinjiang. Given the large size of agricultural production, Xinjiang is often the earliest testing field and adopter of many advanced machinery.
So I understand the mechanization process must have started somewhere. In the beginning, it must have also relied heavily on manual labor. Since when is the mass scale of mechanization introduced here in Xinjiang in cotton production?
In the early days, only a few large farms adopted mechanized production. It wasn't until the 1990s that the level of mechanization in agricultural production began to rise rapidly. In the 1990s, with the sustained improvement of farming techniques, in consideration of the readiness of the local researchers and the features of Xinjiang, we began to roll out the dwarf compact planting and early mature cultivating technique. In the trial production of these new varieties, we began to explore increased mechanization in farming. Initially, we mainly mechanized the sowing, seeding, and intertilling processes. With the development of technology, we have mechanized the entire process of cotton farming. On top of that, today we've even achieved full automation. That's what we call a smart cotton field. We are able to farm a cotton field without manual labor at all.
Could you help us understand if there is still a certain percentage of manual cotton picking versus machinized, mechanized cotton picking in all of Xinjiang?
Before mechanized cotton picking started, there have been challenges in hiring enough laborers to pick cotton manually. Now we have fully mechanized cotton picking in the vast majority of farms in Xinjiang. Mechanized cotton picking is done at 69.85% of farms in Xinjiang, while 90% of cotton picking in northern Xinjiang is done by machine. Why are there still some cotton farms yet to be mechanized? It's because there are farms that grow long staple cotton. Such cotton is very good in quality. However, due to the length and strength of its fiber, the current cotton picking machine is not fit for this purpose. Therefore, it remains difficult to pick such cotton variety with a machine. But last year, we successfully mechanized the harvesting of long staple cotton in Yuepu Lake County of Kashgar. Why are there still some farms that don't have mechanized operations? It's because we have some small holdings, that is, small parcels of land. Most of them are 0.5 to 0.8 acres in size. For such small plots, heavy machinery can't drive in to pick cotton during the harvest season. That's why cotton picking in some farms is not mechanized. For those small farms, it's unnecessary to deploy heavy machinery.
So can you help us understand, in the areas where mechanized cotton picking is not possible or has yet to be made available, how is it organized that people find jobs in picking these cotton? How is this done?
In the past, when mechanized cotton picking was not available, farms in Xinjiang would issue hiring notices to employ laborers who would otherwise sit idle in provinces such as Sichuan, Gansu, and Henan. They would then travel to Xinjiang to pick cotton. There used to be a lot of media coverage about such laborers. We even had trains designated to transport cotton pickers to Xinjiang. They have made substantial contributions to the cotton harvest in Xinjiang. For the farm that still requires manual cotton picking, the labor need has fallen drastically. In fact, if the farm is only 0.5 to 0.8 acres in size, then the owner's family members would be enough to pick all the cotton within a short period of time.
Do we still have workers from southern Xinjiang to go to northern Xinjiang, or from one place in southern Xinjiang to another place in southern Xinjiang in order to pick cotton? Is it still happening?
There are very few workers going from southern Xinjiang to northern Xinjiang to pick cotton. There are still some workers going from one place in southern Xinjiang to another place in southern Xinjiang to pick cotton. But the size of that workforce is small. That's why the remuneration for picking a kilo of cotton is very high. It means a very handsome income for a family. So when workers feel like they have plenty of time, they would like to go and pick cotton.
Is there a difference in terms of ethnicity where these cotton picking workers come from?
Cotton pickers come from different ethnic groups. It's not that they come only from one particular ethnic group. Many households have laborers who may sit idle at home, so if they can go to pick cotton, their family income will get a boost. There is no difference in terms of ethnicity where these cotton pickers come from.
What was your reaction when you heard stories about Xinjiang cotton containing so-called forced labor? Therefore, this NGO that's called Better Cotton Initiative gave out a statement, or the brands, fashion brands associated with this initiative decided not to use cotton from Xinjiang.
I found it absurd. I have been doing cotton research for many years, and I have been to almost all the cotton growing areas in Xinjiang. I have never seen forced labor. As researchers, we have been working to make the cotton farming in Xinjiang more labor-saving and tech-driven. That is what we have been doing and is what we always pursue. For example, in the past, we needed to carry out cotton topping. This process required a lot of labor. During topping, workers had to enter the cotton field, which might spread pests and diseases in the field. So, Professor Zhao Qiang from our university developed the chemical topping method. It not only cut the manual labor needed for the process, but also reduced the spread of pests and diseases in the field. For those who talked about forced labor, I don't think they've ever been to Xinjiang or seen any farming practice in the cotton fields.
So, although you think it is funny and that no such forced labor is taking place, and yet quite some brands actually have made similar statement that they're not going to cooperate with cotton producers or cotton farmers in Xinjiang, has there been any negative impact, or is there going to be any negative impact in the future?
At present, there is no impact on Xinjiang cotton. Because of its high yield and good quality, the demand for Xinjiang cotton will remain solid in the future. For us, as cotton researchers and producers, we will continue to drive cotton production with better technology so that we can supply more and better cotton to the market. I believe that the cotton from Xinjiang will have a brighter future.
Do you think it is necessary that China has its own cotton association or cotton quality standards? Right now we have a Chinese cotton association, but there are only about 300 members also. Do you think it is necessary that China has its own cotton standard?
Cotton standards are actually very important. So far, China has also established many cotton standards. We want to establish our own standards and our own community to improve the influence of our cotton. Right now, China has established a National Cotton Industry Alliance, which is dedicated to achieving these goals. In the near future, I believe we will do better in the standardization of cotton production.